Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest plays the lovable yet powerful Aunt Vi on Queen Sugar, whose character exemplifies what black love looks like and what a woman will do to keep her family together. Take a look.
You the one that had to clean up to come see me, because you know you ain't nothing. I got the money. I got the house. Love. And you got nothing.
Ooh, my God. Bring him down, honey. Please welcome to the circle the beautiful and talented Tina Lifford.
Yes! Hello.
Hey, ladies.
Ooh, watch your step. You look so gorgeous.
You got a sachet on out here, honey.
Yes.
How are you,
pumpkin?
It's so good to see you.
It's so nice to be seen.
Absolutely. Yes. Queen Sugar, such beautifully complex show.
It really is.
What does it feel like to be a part of Ava DuVernay's vision for this?
You know what's beautiful about that is that it feels better and better every season.
Right.
Season 4 has been by far, to my mind, our best season. The storyline was so compelling. Working with, you know, it is clear that Ava is
the
a
bomb.
Visionary.
Oh yes. My gosh.
It is absolutely clear that she loves our stories and that she tells our stories in a way that lets us truly feel like we're seen. And that's really exciting. I mean, that's such an important gift that she is giving to the community.
Yes.
And not just the black community.
Everyone.
But, you know, races across the color line are now being able to see African Americans in the way that a lot of us see ourselves.
So yes, true.
For the first time.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Well, I love seeing you play Aunt Vi. I do. You do an amazing job at it. I feel the character. And like, we know this character. We have Aunt Vi in every one of our families. You know, she's responsible for the family. She loves passionately the family. And she keeps everyone together. What do you like about playing this character?
Yes.
You know what I love is that somewhere in season one, I woke up and went, oh my God, Aunt Vi is an archetype. You know, that person that we all know, but we haven't seen on television before. And here, for the first time, African Americans are being able to see, and not just African Americans, people know Aunt Vi.
Yes.
They either have an Aunt Vi in their family, they want to be Aunt Vi, or they've been loved by an Aunt Vi.
Yes, guys.
Right?
Yes.
That's an archetype.
It is.
Yeah.
It really is.
And this is the first time that we're seeing it in all these years of television.
I know. And you know, this show, it really just hones in on so many different topics, especially domestic violence. Talk about being that part, you know, having to experience that part of the storyline. We saw that particular clip. What does that mean to you to bring domestic violence to the forefront and actually see the healing that you experience as a character?
I'll tell you that when that episode 12 aired, there were just so many posts and comments. A number of women who have actually lived through the trauma and drama of domestic violence, and they were saying, you said what I never had the opportunity to say. And so in that way, again, Queen Sugar is, you know, bringing value and healing through entertainment.
Yes, absolutely.
And for me, you know, an actress wants to be a place where people can see themselves and their stories matter.
And that's right. And you absolutely matter because you are just so prolific as an artist. It is just gorgeous to witness. Queen Sugar airs on OWN. And for those of you who are staying with us, we get more of this lovely lady at the table.
And of course, the conversations continue on all social media platforms at Sister Circle TV.
Yes, the one and only Tina Lifford. Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We are here with Queen Sugar's Tina Lifford. We had to bring her to the table because she's just so amazing. Yes, you are.
Yes,
so welcome to the table.
Happy to be at the table.
Yes.
To you.
Yes.
To you.
Thank you.
You all do what what you do so
thank
well.
You. Thank you. Thank you so much.
So blessed to us.
Thank you.
Know?
So thank sure. you. Thank
we
you.
Have a lot to cover, Tina. We just want to go ahead and jump right on in. We love the show. We're yes. fans of the show. We're happy that you are a part of the show. But what we're most excited about is you all are displaying black love, yes. especially your character yeah. in Hollywood
yes.
in particular. And we just love it, and we need to see more of it. We don't see a lot of that on television. Why do you think it's important for Hollywood to get that we need to see these positive images of ourselves, especially a strong marriage and a strong love between black people?
Well, I don't know mm-hmm. that Hollywood, you know, the industry gets that. Mm-hmm. I think that the industry has discovered that black folks want to see themselves mm-hmm. and black folks drive industry. We mm-hmm. spend money.
Absolutely.
And so if you put programming on television where we can see mm-hmm. ourselves, we're going to show up.
Yeah.
That's good for business.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What's beautiful is that we've got storytellers mm-hmm. and people like Oprah Winfrey mm-hmm. who are in a position now where our stories can be championed, mm-hmm. they can be greenlit, and we are proving that we are viable commodities mm-hmm.
yes.
within this industry.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. And Quad alluded to it, the chemistry that you share with Hollywood / Omar Dorsey is just so beautifully thick
it
and
really
delicious.
Is.
What from that particular love story do you want in your own life, or do you want that? Or are you looking for that?
Yeah, well, what I... No. Did I do something? Is that some sort of tell? let me say that one of the beautiful things about that relationship that I value in my private relationships, mm-hmm. actually, I require it.
Okay.
And that is a sense of being able to communicate mm-hmm. about anything.
Yes.
I like
you
that.
You know, mm-hmm. even the difficult stuff.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So whether it's with my man or whether it's with girlfriends or whether it's actually with my business team, mm-hmm. I need to know that we can go there, that we can talk okay. about the difficult stuff, that we can do it respectfully,
yeah.
and that we can do it with a sense of vision about where we can go.
Yes.
And I that's the part of the Hollywood and Vi relationship that just opens my heart.
Yeah.
You know, I was dating a lovely man, a mm-hmm. really, really, really lovely man.
Uh-huh.
But too many parts of his life were off limit. And I don't know
you
if-
You can't dig you, deeper you that
can't,
way.
Yeah, you can't be intimate
yeah.
that way.
Yes.
Right? You can't, and people hide stuff because they don't want to be seen. Mm. But when you're hiding, you really can't be seen.
Yes. Mm.
And so you got to risk.
Yeah.
You know, you got to be willing to risk. And if you can risk, then you can open a space where someone can really sit
mm-hmm.
with you, you know, really look you in the eyes, mm-hmm. really see who mm-hmm. you are and understand that you're more than this event.
And possibly have a personal breakthrough, too.
Absolutely.
Okay, yes.
So that you can become more.
Yeah.
Right.
Come
you know,
on now.
You can
yeah.
let more of who you are out.
Yes,
yeah.
yes.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
You know, speaking
Oof.
Of dating and more, you mm-hmm. know, we're talking about more. One of the things that I learned just being on the road about me is that I need more self-care.
Mm-hmm.
And a woman like you that is so busy with a show like Queen Sugar that is just constant, I'm sure it's constant filming all the time, plus your other projects, what is it that you do to take time away for your personal self-care, and how important, what is the priority level, is it? What is the priority level in your life when it comes to self-care?
You just said it. I prioritize.
Ah.
Yes. That's the beginning,
yes.
you know,
mm-hmm.
and understanding that, you know, this thing called success mm-hmm. is a wonderful thing, but people make the mistake
oh my God,
thinking
look at you.
That
mm.
success,
ooh, that's gorgeous.
That's my stylist, Jay Boland.
Yes. Yes.
But people make the mistake thinking that with success, there's going to be automatic happiness.
Yes. Right, right.
Two different skill sets.
You're right.
Tell the people.
Two
shame
different
the devil.
Skill
right.
sets. And you've got to mm-hmm. learn both of those skill sets.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And if you're not paying attention to the skill set for happiness, you're going to wake up with lots of money and power, and then you're going to wonder, why do I feel so bad?
My God, we see it all the time.
Right.
We see it all the time.
Absolutely. So you're trying to help people figure out that balance with your Inner Fitness, Outer Beauty National Tour. Tell us more about that.
Yeah, so in Atlanta, September the 14th, that's this coming Saturday, of bringing two worlds together.
Love mm-hmm. it.
We all love looking good, mm-hmm. right? And
absolutely.
So I'm bringing my Jay stylist, Jay
yeah.
Bowling, to the stage. But more importantly, you got to learn how to dress your spirit, which
that's
means
right.
you got to connect
dress
with
your
it,
spirit.
Right?
Yes,
you
got to
know who you are on the inside, and not just know who you are on the inside, know who you want to become.
Yes.
And know how to say, up until now, life has been this way, mm-hmm. but from this point forward, it can be this way.
Yes.
And that's what we're doing at the Inner Fitness
so
Outer Beauty Tour.
Inside exercise.
Yes. Yes. That's
exactly
what it is.
Yes.
I like that.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
Yeah. Well, you've also been exercising your thought process. Mm-hmm. You have a book that's on the horizon. Mm-hmm. The Little Book of Big Lies.
Yes.
Oh, my
yes.
God.
Yes.
I read that. I said, oh, she's going to be talking about something in that book. She really is. So it drops in November. What can the readers expect from this book?
Well, here's what I'd love to leave you with. There's a self inside of you, and you need to prioritize it. You need to take care of it. And more importantly, any event that has ever taken place in your life that has left you feeling less than, not good enough, incapable, or limited is a lie.
Hmm.
And you got to figure out how to let go of that lie yeah. and take your power back from
my
it.
Gosh. I like that. Mm-hmm.
You have spoken
that's
a
good.
Word here down to the circle today.
It's a lie, y'all. If it made you feel bad, it was a lie
that's
anyway.
Exactly. Right.
Time I walk in the door. This is
what got words. Can we please give it up for the amazing Tina
yes.
Lifford? Thank you so much.
Ladies, yes. thank you.
Thank you so much for being with us. And remember, Queen Sugar airs on OWN Network. And if you're in the Atlanta area, go to TinaLifford.com. For more information on her Inner Fitness Outer Beauty Tour here in Atlanta.
This Saturday.
And tell Jay Bowling, we want him on the show.
Yeah.
I love him.
Jay
I love him.